Hello, Mermeet. Welcome to another one of my Venefica's occult findings. I'm not sure exactly what number this is. It's 20-something. Anyway, I have a lot of stuff to show, so I will get started. And this is a collective haul. I've collected this over the last 2 months or so. And yeah, it's basically things I've gotten since the last time I did one of these videos. So, let's begin one. With magazines. First is a Norwegian New Age magazine, Ildsjel, translated The Fire Soul, and this is number 6, 2013. I think they have 6 number publications a year. And then we have Medium, number 12, 2013. This is my favorite New Age magazine, but usually it's expensive, but this one was on sale. Because really, I like magazines to read on the bus and train and such things, but when a magazine is so expensive, I might as well have bought a book, then yeah, I have to be smart because in it that I really, really, really want to read them. There's one I haven't opened yet because I haven't had the time to read it. That Nära, which means near. It's a Swedish New Age magazine. And it is number 1, 2014. So it's brand new. It comes with this angel, there we go, calendar. Which I should get out of that and up on my wall. And then we have Nära, and I think I might have shown this. It was in the pile I haven't shown. But yeah, the Nära number 8, 2013. So if I've shown it already, please forgive me. And then Light of Consciousness. Journal of Spiritual Awakening, which is basically a yoga and meditation magazine. I didn't like that one too much because it's a bit too advanced for me. Basically, I like yoga, but being a bigger woman, there's a lot of these various poses I can't get into. So I have this instruction CD, instruction DVD, basically for yoga for overweight people, and I love it. But yeah, so I'm not sure I'm gonna buy more of those magazines. We'll see. Then we have Soul and Spirit, and this is back issue. It's issue 58, November 2012, and here comes some advertisement. Dropping out of it. I hate those advertisement inserts. But yeah, there we go. And we have another one I haven't had time to open yet. Because I got it in the mail not long ago. And it is Spirit and Destiny. January 2014. I try to get Spirit and Destiny every month. It's a British New Age magazine. And another one I haven't read because it got in the I got it in the middle of the Christmas season and I put it somewhere just to read it. And I sort of forgot about it and I just found it when looking, when finding the stuff I was going to do a haul with. So yeah. It's Spirit and Destiny, December 2013. So I'll have something to read. And then we have well, I'm not sure if I've shown it or not. I have then I'm sorry, but again it was in the pile of things I haven't shown. So Spirit and Destiny, November 2013. So well, that's out of the way. Yes, let's get on to the books. And the first one I want to show is Living Paganism, And this is one of the few more advanced pagan books. Basically, there's a lot of beginner books. This is one that takes it a step further. So, yeah, if you're looking for that, you might want to look into this. And that, yeah, made it. It's from New Page Books, and it's by, how am I gonna pronounce it? Chandramon. Sounds like a Pokemon. I assume he isn't. There is his name. Or her. Definitely looks like a Pokemon. Chandramon, I shoot you. Sorry, busy, can't fight, writing book. Anyway, moving on. Mixing essential oils for magic. Aromic Alchemy for personal blends. By Sandra Kynes, and it's by Levelin. I love essential oils. My mother works with them professionally, so I've sort of grown up with them. So yeah. And then I have Chinese Healing Exercises, a personalized practice for health and longevity by Stephen Chadosa. I love that author, and I love these kinds of Chinese healing exercises. It's, for example, in the same category, you would find, for example, the Do, as in the Dare exercise. And so on. So yeah, and it's also published by Levelin. And then I have Levelin's 2014 Herbal Almanac. It's one of their almanacs I haven't reviewed yet. So I'm hoping to get to this pretty soon. Like I said, I've been trying to include herbs more in my work, so I've been starting to pick up these for some years, and there's so much good information in here. And speaking of Levelin's yearly companion things, you have Levelin's 2014 Witches Companion, which I'm also hoping to review pretty soon. And then and of course those two are by Levelin. I thought that's pretty obvious since they are Levelin's 2014, so on. So yeah. Then we have To Walk a Pagan Path, Practical Spirituality for Every Day by Alaric Albertson. And it's also published by Levelin. Anything that's sort of daily magic, daily spirituality thing, I just eat it up, because I do, like I've said before, really feel it's important to bring your religion and your magic into your everyday life. It shouldn't just be something that sits on a pedestal and just get picked up in the most dire of situations. It should be something that's part of your life, at least in my opinion. Of course you don't need to abide by my opinion. And in trying to learn more about Russian witchcraft, I have The Cult in Russian and Soviet Culture, edited by Bernice Glatzer Rosenthal. Yes. And it's by Cornell. And I have The Rich and Healthy Witch, The Essential Survival Guide for Magical People by Starfields. I have a feeling that is not her given name. And it's by Dragon Rising Publishing. So yeah, what this is, it's an amazing book. I do really recommend it, and I'm going to do a review on it. Basically, what it is about is we that practice magic we tend to look at life a little bit different, and it's very difficult for other people to understand us. And it's basically how to survive as somebody who has a different view, different outlook of life, and often different problems than everybody else. Like, we pick up energies that disturb our day, and so on and so forth. Basically, how to deal with all of that. So, yeah, I really do recommend this book. And I have A Practical Eden's Guide to Autotune by Patricia M. Lafayette. That person. And it's also by Llewellyn. And I'm always skeptical when I see books about autotune, because a lot of authors really bungle it. It's like they are allergic to research. But had to pick it up anyway and see how it is, and if it's not correct, it might still have some good ideas in there. So that is that. And I have a book that's named You Are a Medium, Discover Your Natural Abilities to Communicate with the Other Side by Cherie Dillard. And it's by Llewellyn. And that's one I knew I had to have as soon as I saw the title. It's Pagan Anger Magic, Positive Transformation from Negative Energies by Tammy Sullivan. And it's by Citadel Press Kensington. And basically what this is, I mean, anger, it's a lot of energy in anger. Basically how to keep that energy, those basically very negative feelings, and use that to fuel positive changes, positive spells, and so on and so forth. Using energy to fuel the spells is brilliant. And again, like I said, if there's anything of things I point out here, basically show here, that you would like to see a review of, just post it down in the comment section, and I will try to get around to it as soon as I can. Can't make any promises, but I'll try as good as I can. And then I have the Essential Doreen Virtue Collection, which is basically a collection of three of her books. And it's by Hay House. Let's see which books it was. It was the Angel Therapy, Healing with Angels, and Archangels and Ascended Masters. Now, what do I think about Doreen? We have the Inner Doreen Virtue. She can be a bit full of herself at times, she can be a bit too commercial, but generally I actually think her books are pretty good. I mean, and this book was really, really cheap, and it's hardcover, and it's 3 books in one, so yeah. Can't pass that up. I'm making a power of books here that I'm hoping won't fall. And then I have Supermarket Magic by Michelle Furry. With the title Creating Spells, Brews, Potions, and Powders of Everyday Ingredients. And it's by Llewellyn. So again, I really like magic brought into the everyday there. So, yeah. Have to pick that up. And then I have more on Russian occultism. I have The Bathhouse at Midnight, A Historical Survey of Magic and Divination in Russia by W.F. Ryan. And it's by Penn State Press. And then I have this book that I commented on in another video. The New Orleans Voodoo Handbook by Kenaz Pilan. And I'll probably do a review of it too at some point. I just haven't gotten around to it. And it's by Destiny Books. Destiny Books. And I have soul numbers. Decipher the messages from your inner self to successfully navigate life. So, yeah, and it's by Michelle Abrao. And yeah, it's an interesting book on numerology. Only thing I don't like about it is it has that so velvety feel to it that I've criticized Llewellyn for sometimes having. But this isn't Llewellyn, this is Premier. And if you thought the Llewellyn books that do this is bad, this one is horrible. It, when you touch the book, it sort of leaves that sticky feeling on your hands. It's horrible. We stop doing this. It doesn't feel good on the hand. So perhaps I'm the only one that feels that way. But yeah, it doesn't please me. The book itself, however, is pretty good. So, yeah. And then I have Mind, Body, and Home. Transform Your Life, One Room at a Time by Tricia Morris. Basically what this is Western Feng Shui. So yeah, I thought that was interesting. And it's by Llewellyn. And I have The Tarot of Awakening, Initiation into the Kabbalistic Western Mystery Tradition, Amy N. Wall. I haven't read this book yet. It's basically Western mysticism and occultism as tied in with the tarot. And it is published by someone that doesn't want to show. Perhaps it's self-published in some way. Desert Mystery Publishing, is it? That's the Desert Mystery Publishing. Oh yeah, the this one, the Western Feng Shui book, Mind, Body, and Home, is by Llewellyn. What can I say? I like Llewellyn's books. Anyway, I'm talking about this one. One thing I really hate. Earlier, when I bought these from Amazon, they always tied the books down to a piece of sturdy cardboard and used some some sort of plastic to sort of mummify the book onto that so they stayed put. Very often they don't do that anymore, or they don't use enough plastic, so the books rumble around in the box. It results in things like this. And that annoys me. When I pay full price for a book that is new, I want it to arrive in new condition. Problem is, if I complain about this, what I do is that I send me a new one, because I've done that at an earlier time, and then I have to send the old one back, and shipping from Norway to the United States are pretty horrible. So yeah, too much hustle for compared to what it's worth. So yeah, I wish Amazon would take more care. Oh, yeah. And then I have one that I have reviewed. The Serenity Solution, How to Use Quiet Contemplation to Solve Life's Problems by Keith Hart. And it's also by Llewellyn. This has that velvety thingy, but it's not as bad as the other one at least. And another one that I have reviewed, Llewellyn's Witches State Book 2014. And then I have Fairies and Elementals for Beginners, Learn About and Communicate with Nature Spirits by Alexandra Sharam. And it's by Llewellyn. I think these for beginners books are excellent. They are pretty nice introductions to a topic. And also, even if you have some experience in it, there's usually a lot of useful information in these. And they tend to be relatively cheap. So, I have Energy of Words by Michelle Abrao. Use the vibrations of language to manifest the life you desire, and it's by Levellen. And I think it's absolutely wonderful. I have just gotten it. I got it yesterday, and I haven't read all of it yet, but so far it seems amazing. It's basically how to change things in your world, manifest things using language. I mean, there's so many magic systems based on that. And even, I mean, the word spell, it's about language, is spelling it out. So, yeah. This is a pretty good book, and like I said, it was by Levelle. And then I have Magical Tarot, Mystical Tale. How do you pronounce it in English? Unlocking the Hidden Power of the Tarot Using Ancient Secrets of the Tao Te Ching. By Diane Morgan. And it's by St. Martin's Griffin. I am very interested in Taoist thinking, and combining that with Tarot you've seen, so interesting that when I saw this book, it was an impulse buy. When I saw this book, I just had to have it. And here is another book that I have reviewed. It's Levellen's 2014 Magical Almanac, Practical Magic for Everyday Living. Of course, by Levellen. And I see that the video is getting very, very long. Okay, we have the Wisdom of Hypatia, I think it is. The Wisdom of Hypatia. Ancient Spiritual Practices for a More Meaningful Life by Bruce J. McLennan. And it is by Levellen. And the last book I've gotten is The Reiki Manual, a training guide for Reiki students, practitioners, and masters, by Penelope Quest and Kathy Roberts. And it's by Teacher Penguin. So yeah, I'm very, very interested in Reiki, and anything that has to do with system that's based on direct energy manipulation, energy healing, that sort of things. Those are my favorite paradigms to work with. So yeah, I tend to go a bit gaga over Reiki books. But my mother is a Reiki practitioner, and she can do some amazing shit with that. So yeah, looking forward to digging into this book. I also got this one yesterday. So, on to some pendulums. And the first one is one that I forgot to show last time. It came in this cute little box. I'm probably not gonna store it in that box. I'm probably gonna take it out, perhaps paint it and use it for something else. Perhaps storing some incense cones or something like that. Anyway. In here we find this most adorable little pendulum. You can see the pendulum itself is a little witch. There we go. It's a little witch with her cat, and it just hangs from two little loops. I mean, it's not the best pendulum because it's a bit, it doesn't dangle very well down here, and it's not very heavy. It made from some sort of clay. But, I mean, it's a little green witch with her cap, and the figurine is just so incredibly detailed. Let me see if I can get a close-up of her face. Sorry for reminding. There we go. Isn't that amazing? So yeah, those were. She was also one of the things that I saw and was. Oh, mine. No, like those seagulls in Finding Nemo. Mine. So yeah, I've also gotten this pendulum. It's it's blue sandstone, which isn't actually a stone, it's an official material, but, and it hangs from a chain, and the chain, and the handle is a heart with wings. And here's something that I have been looking for so long, and I've been wanting one, and finally I actually found one, and it's a huge ass rock crystal pendulum. So yeah, the pendulum itself, and it looks amazing. Let's see if we can get it into picture. It's this double terminated rock crystal that is held with silver wire. And it's has nothing stuff. Lapis lazuli on the top. And it has this little dangle thingy here, so that I can take basically the chain like this, just let it hang there, and I can put this on a chain. It would be a nice pendant, and also it's a good way to have it suck up my energies and get more attuned to me, and it hangs from pretty short chain and has this little moon and star. And it's so amazing to work with because it's so heavy, and I really, really like heavy pendulums. So, yeah, I'm so happy about getting that one. That is that! That's another goodies here. Let's move on to. Yeah, I have one more pendulum. Black tourmaline. It's from basically, it's this warrior's crystal piece that's the pendulum itself. Hangs from this tumble piece by just a silvery chain. And I went back to look at this one, I bought it on eBay again and again and again and again because it's so pretty. And it sort of looks like something from an alien planet. Really had that sci-fi feel to it. And it's amazing to work with. This is fairly heavy, so yeah, glad I got that. And now onto some stones. What are these called in English? But it says so. The problem is, I'm not. They are pink garnet, a type of pink garnet. But how is it to be pronounced? Rhodolite? Rhodonite? I think it's rhodonite. Yeah. These stones usually have other names in Norwegian, so I have to learn them all again in English. Anyway, it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 tumble pieces. And I just got fascinated by this stone all of a sudden, so I went on eBay and had these 5 tumble pieces for, I think it was $5 or something. I think this one is a good one. So, I mean, when you get fascinated by stone like that, that usually tends to mean that you have a need of it. So yeah, I think that was a good buy. So I haven't worked with this yet. But, yeah. And I have another piece of rhodonite here. Is this spare? And, I mean, they were selling this for $4. And I bought one. It was the last one I had that was rhodonite. And then the seller writes me and say, they don't have any more rhodonite, would I want to another type of stones and say, yeah, sure, I picked another type of stone. Because $4 for a stone square is still pretty cheap on Norwegian standards. But then, when it arrived, it was through the night anyway, so, yeah. I guess I got lucky there. Perhaps I found one more in the storage, or something like that. And then I have this little baggie of tiny little stone shards. It came with that rock crystal pendulum as a bonus. Also got some necklaces as a bonus, so that's nice. Always like free stuff. So, what do we have here? We have tiny hematite. There are some very, very tiny shards here. What I might do with those is when I make like spell bags or to dig down and put into the in flower pots for the flowers to grow better and those sort of things. This tiny little rock crystal point. This is so adorable. It's just so adorable. It's the tiniest little crystal or other, I think it's smoky quartz with inclusions point. It's just the most adorable thing you've ever seen. Another little piece of rock crystal, a piece of selenite, saltstone, citrine, and some really, really tiny ones here. I'm not sure what this is actually, it's so tiny. I think it might be garnet. And we have some blue ones here that, you know, it's a green, so this piece aventurine. And this is also aventurine. So yeah, those little tiny shards. I mean, this one is a decent size, so that can be used. And that tiny, tiny little point here. And it doesn't really feel like it's broken off either. It just seems like that's how it... It doesn't really feel like it was broken off a bigger piece. The others do. So I'm probably going to keep that one, because it's so cute and so tiny. While the others I will probably use for mojo bags or to dig down in flower pots and things like that. Oh, come on, the last piece, let's get real there as well. Yeah. And then I have this Tibetan singing bowl. I have one more stone. I have this green stone that I've actually forgotten what was called. I just saw it in the last few seconds of it's basically an auction, got it very cheap, but it was pretty, and I thought that I don't have this stone, I don't know anything about it, I can always read up about it. So yeah, it's green, transparent, so I do have it somewhere where it, what it is, but I've actually forgotten what it is. But it's very pretty, I see it turns up as yellow on the screen, but it is actually soft candy green. Yeah, and I have this Tibetan singing bowl, and it was cheap. It was like $5 or $6, which is very, very cheap. They're usually extremely expensive. It's very pretty around. And I thought that if it doesn't work as a singing bowl, it will be, don't drop it, amazing as an altar bowl. And does it work? Sort of. It has a pleasant sound, it's just very tiny. So, don't know if that will be picked up, but it's like... It does have a very pleasant sound that is very calming. The sound is just very tiny. I have another singing bowl that's bigger and better quality, and it has a much more pronounced sound. So, does it work as a singing bowl? Yes, but it's... doesn't work extremely well, but it does work, so yeah. And then I'm going to move on to some divination cards. A lot of these I haven't begun to work with yet, because I don't have the time, and I've sort of had a crappy start for the year, been sick, I've been feeling very down and such. I haven't felt like starting any new project, but yeah. I have the Harmony with the Universe Oracle cards by Vendit Tripleton. And it came with a Soul and Spirit magazine. I love to get these kinds of extras because they tend to end up as pretty weird sets, and yeah. Also is a bit, little bit near and there to me, because the very first divination deck I got was actually one that I got in a magazine. And I mean, I was a very, I don't think I was a teenager, 11 or so, and got them out of a magazine that my grandmother had. And actually I lost my first set, but then my school was throwing out some magazines they had. And I saw that it was exactly the same magazine that had those cards, and I opened it and they actually had them, so I got a new set and I still have that. So it's like, it was meant to be that I should have them. But yeah. And then I have this one, it's Death Note Tarot. And I have several of these types of tarot cards. I haven't read with them because they're not really the type for that. Well, of course they are, but they don't work very well for that. I have them both because I'm an anime fan and because, well, I collect tarot decks and I sort of a novelty. And then we have one that I have been really looking forward to, which is probably one, the first one I'm going to really dig into. It's the Blow Cap Tarot, I bet. Salomon, and it has these very simple and yet very, very serene drawings. Like, this is one of them. This is how the cards are drawn, and it's just amazing. So I can't wait to dig into that. There's another novelty deck. Silicon Valley Tarot. Yeah, it's basically tarot geek style. And it's by Steve Jackson Games. It was rare for a long time and fetched extreme prices, but I don't know what's happened, if it's been republished or something like that, because I paid like $20 or something like for that one. So, and it's gone for $200-$300 for a while, so I thought, okay, I want that deck, but I'm not going to pay that much for it. But I saw that when I typed in Silicon Valley Tarot, now they had many of them for $15, $20, $30, they're about. So yeah, obviously, probably republished it. And then I have Indigo Angel Oracle cards by Doreen Virtue and Charles Virtue. And it's basically hinted towards Indigo children and that sort of thing, but I think it works for anyone, and the cards are so beautiful. So yeah, I'm definitely gonna do a review of this one. And for the last thing, and then this video will finally be over, and I apologize if you hate long videos, is the Conscious Spirit Oracle deck by Kim Dreyer. Here's an example of the cards. I haven't started looking into this one yet either. So yeah, I'm gonna start looking forward to doing that. So yeah, I hope you have enjoyed this haul. Yeah, sorry that the video got that long. Have a great day. It was a big